In the last few hours, James Wolfe, a former senior staffer on the Senate Intelligence Committee, appeared in court, charged with lying repeatedly to the FBI about his contacts with three journalists. Now, as part of this investigation, the Trump Justice Department secretly obtained phone and email records of at least one of those reporters, New York Times journalist Ali Watkins, who covers national security issues. Watkins was notified about these intrusions into her records by the U.S. government after the fact, making it impossible for her to challenge this questionable search and seizure in court before it happened. Free press advocates, including those of us who bring you this show, consider this action by the Trump administration diving into a reporter's phone and email records to see who her sources may be to be an egregious intrusion on the First Amendment. A spokeswoman for the New York Times says, quote, "Freedom of the press is a cornerstone of democracy, and communications between journalists and their sources demand protection." The editor of BuzzFeed, where Watkins used to work, stated, quote, "We're deeply troubled by what looks like a case of law enforcement interfering with a reporter's constitutional right to gather information about her own government," unquote. Now, the Obama administration also repeatedly attacked press freedoms, and we called it out at the time. It was heinous then, and it's just as contemptible now. Questions we have about this incident include the following. If the Senate Intelligence Committee staffer was charged with lying and not charged with leaking, how bad could these leaks have been? Is the Trump administration escalating the Obama administration's war on leaks by trampling on the First Amendment for the disclosure of information that isn't even particularly sensitive? Another question, why seize Watkins' phone and email records, all of them, if you're only looking into one of her possible sources? Because the Trump administration now may not just have information about one of the sources for this national security reporter, they're potentially getting information about a whole bunch of those sources. Are there any safeguards at all here? Or is the Trump administration just blithely combing through the records of a national security reporter? Another question, how much does President Trump's disdain for the Fourth Estate play into any of this? How breezily was this done? There's no apparently pressing national security crisis involved. Did anyone even debate this at the Justice Department? Lastly, how many other reporters is the Justice Department doing this to under the shroud of secrecy? Now, to those Trump supporters out there who don't care about this issue, I will remind you of what I said when it was the Obama administration violating press freedom, specifically when the Obama administration was taking unusual steps in a leak investigation to go after a Fox News journalist. I'm a journalist. Obviously, I have a bias here. But even if you side with this president over those of us in the media who challenge him and his administration, it is important to remember the precedent these actions set going forward, perhaps when it's not your guy in the White House. As the Freedom of the Press Foundation put it today, this case, quote, chills all investigative journalism and damages the public's right to know, unquote. Your right to know.